The official Dan Man has asked, gapless rings, are they okay for everyday use? Can I use one as the compression ring and then use a normal ring below that? Okay, so for those who aren't aware, gapless rings don't actually have no gap. What they are is a two-piece ring. So what we do is we install the first part of the ring, and then the second part of the ring is installed with the end gap 180 degrees opposed from the first part of the ring. So what this does is basically gives no path for the combustion pressure to escape through. I've used gapless rings from Total Seal myself in some of our competition engines, and what I find is that they do provide a lower leak down reading. On the dyno, I've never actually seen this translate specifically to an increase in power though, although it's hard because we don't normally work in a laboratory situation where we're only making one single change of just trying the difference between rings. But I've never really seen that translate to an increase in power. What we do find in general though is with the, my own experience with the Total Seal gapless ring, is that their life expectancy is relatively short. So they're probably perfectly suited to a race engine that's going to get regular strip downs, probably not so suitable for a street engine that's going to see long periods between strip downs and rebuilds.
That question was taken from one of our free live lessons. If you like free stuff and you're the type of guy who wants to expand your knowledge, click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson. You'll learn about performance engine building and EFI tuning, and you'll also have the chance to ask your own questions, which I'll be answering live. Remember, it's 100% free, so follow the link to claim your spot.